You are in the process of reaching out to literary agents in the hopes of getting representation and ultimately getting your book published by a major publishing house, then you know that a part of the query letter process is writing up a blurb about your book. This is what the agent will review when looking over your query letter and will ultimately help them decide if it is a project that they are interested in taking on. In fact, the blurb in the query letter might be arguably the most important part of your query letter, as it is the part of the letter that the agent is going to review in order to decide if they are really interested in reading your sample pages and even requesting your full manuscript. Now, admittedly, some agents do tend to skip right to the sample pages and just gloss over that blurb, but still, it is very, very important for you to have a really enticing and well-crafted blurb in that query letter so that you can have the strongest query letter possible. Your goal with the blurb is to make the agent feel like this is something they absolutely have to read. But there is a lot of confusion about the blurb, what it is, what it should look like, and what it should sound like, and how it differs from a synopsis. So I want to clear all of that up today and give you the top do's and don'ts of how to write a blurb for your novel for a query letter. I am also going to use a real life example from a successfully published book so that you can get a taste of what that blurb really looks like in practice. If this type of content is interesting to you and you are anywhere along the book writing or book publishing journey, I recommend subscribing to my channel. I talk a lot about how to get a literary agent, how to approach the publishing process, and how to strengthen your book writing overall. So I'd love to have you around. So before I get into the do's and don'ts of writing a novel blurb, I need to clear up what a blurb is and how it differs from a synopsis. There's a lot of confusion between these two terms, and they're sometimes used incorrectly and interchangeably. So I'm going to make sure that you have a clear understanding of what each one is and what it is used for. Think of the blurb as a movie trailer of your book. It really just gives the person reading it a taste or a teaser of what your book is all about. This is very, very similar to the book jacket copy or the description copy that you find either on the description page of the book online or if you flip over to the back cover of a hardcover book. Sometimes in paperbacks, it's also on the inside flap. That is really what a blurb sounds like. It just gives you an idea of what the story is about so that the person reading it ultimately decides if it's something that they're interested in or not. The most important thing to remember here is that the blurb does not give away the entire story. It really just gives that taste or teaser. The blurb is an integral part of the query letter and it will always be included in your query letter. The synopsis, on the other hand, is not always necessary and it is kind of an optional separate document. The synopsis gives away the entirety of your novel step by step. It explains exactly what happens through the beginning, middle, and the ending. And you really only need a synopsis if the agent specifically requests one. If they don't request one, don't give it to them. Now, if you do need to write a synopsis or you're in the process of working on one, I recommend checking out my recent video on the do's and don'ts of writing that synopsis. And there's some tips there that will help you make sure you're doing the right things with that document. But now back to the blurb. I'm gonna start by reading an example of a blurb that really hits all the right notes and does all the right things and checks all the boxes. And then I'm going to walk through those do's and don'ts step by step and show you exactly how the blurb operates and why it works so well. So this example is from a novel, a thriller, called Tell Me Everything by Cambria Brockman. This is a book that I love and it has a personal sentimental value to me because I worked on this book whenever I was at Random House. So let me go ahead and read the blurb, which in this case is also the description that is being used to sell the book online and the description that actually goes on the cover of the book. In her first weeks at Hawthorne College, Malin is swept up into a tight-knit circle that will stick together through all 4 years. There's Gemma, an insecure theater major from London, John, a tall, handsome, wealthy New Englander, Max, John's cousin, a shy pre-med major, Khalid, a wisecracking prince from Abu Dhabi, and Ruby, a beautiful art history major. But Malin isn't like the rest of her friends. She's an expert at hiding her troubled past. She acts as if she shares the preoccupations of those around her, dating, partying, all while using her extraordinary insight to detect their deepest vulnerabilities and weaknesses. By senior day, on the cusp of graduation, Malin's secrets and those of her friends are revealed, While she scrambles to maintain her artfully crafted image, her missteps set in motion a devastating chain of events that ends in a murder. And as fragile relationships hang in the balance and close alliances shift, Malin must test the limits of what she's capable of to stop the truth from coming out. So did that make you want to read the book? I hope so. But I really do think that this blurb illustrates a lot of the things that are really, really important in your novel blurb. So let's talk through all of the do's and don'ts that you need to keep in mind. The first do is that you want to make sure you're introducing your main character or characters. In most cases, it works really well to introduce the protagonist in that opening line. And if your novel has multiple protagonists that carry equal weight, or if it has multiple shifting points of view, you want to make sure that you include all of those protagonists in the blurb. This is because after the agent reads the blurb, they're going to be looking out for those characters in the pages and ultimately in the full manuscript if you send them the whole thing. And so you want to make sure you're setting up those expectations for who they are going to meet in the novel. It also really helps the agent from the get-go connect with the people in the story and really give them a sense of whose story it really is and what these characters are all about. So the example blurb does this really well with the opening line. It says, "In her first weeks at Hawthorne College, Malin is swept up into a tight-knit circle that will stick together through all 4 years." So we immediately understand, you know, that Malin is at college and she is starting that four-year journey. And so we understand kind of where she is in life and the point at which the novel enters and starts to follow her. My first don't for writing a novel blurb in your query letter is you really don't want to use prefatory language that says, "In my story," or "this novel starts with." That's because you really want to dive right in to the story itself. That's a much more dynamic and engaging and exciting way to get the agent's interest. They understand that this is your novel and that this is your story, so you really don't need to use that type of prefatory language. Even though I know it might feel wrong to just abruptly dive into the description, that is what you want to do, because remember that the query letter is a very, very concise letter. The agent is only going to spend a certain number of seconds or maybe a minute reading it, so you want to cut out kind of any extraneous text like this prefatory language. You only have a limited number of words to pique the agent's interest, so you want to make sure you keep it as clean as possible. My next do for writing a novel blurb is to specify your story's main conflict. This is really, really important, and far too often in the first or second draft of this blurb, it's much too vague. You do want to give the agent really some sense of what specifically your story is about and what specifically the characters are going through. For example, using language like "your character runs into obstacles" or "faces many challenges" really doesn't give the agent a sense of what those specific challenges and obstacles are, so I would avoid that language and really be more specific and detailed. That said, you don't want to give everything away, so there is a type of balance that you're going to need to find. Keep in mind that you really are only going to have the time and space to talk about those first couple of moments in the plot, because again, the blurb is not the place to give away your entire story. So you really just want to set up those first inciting incidents and pique the agent's interest so that they want to read the rest of how that story plays out and understand how that conflict actually manifests in the story. By senior day, on the cusp of graduation, Malin's secrets and those of her friends are revealed. While she scrambles to maintain her artfully curated image, her missteps set in motion a devastating chain of events that ends in a murder. This example really toes that balance of giving the agent enough information without being overly vague. So we understand that secrets about Malin's life are going to be revealed, and we also understand that there's going to be a murder, which is immediately a specific point in the story that is going to intrigue the agent. But at the same time, there's enough mystery here because we don't know exactly the nature of those secrets, and of course we don't know who is murdered or who is the murderer. So it also leaves a little bit of mystery for the agent to be excited to uncover. A big don't with the novel blurb is you don't want to give away too many details. For example, you really don't need to name every single secondary character, and you don't need to get into every single subplot. You really just want to talk about the high-level main point of conflict. Again, the agent is only going to give really a quick pass through that blurb, so you really just want to present them the main character and the main conflict. You frankly just don't have enough room to go into all of the complexities and all of the details of your story. And that's okay. As you are closing your novel blurb, the biggest do to keep in mind is that you want to entice the agent to discover what happens. After all, that is the whole point of the blurb to begin with. So it's really important to end the blurb with a sentence that compels the agent to then dive into your sample pages and ultimately request the full manuscript. To do this, you want to make sure you're introducing some question or element of suspense. This could be a literal rhetorical question. I honestly don't mind one in the novel blurb. Some people don't like it though. The reason I like at least thinking about a rhetorical question, even if you don't end up putting it as a question in the blurb, is because you want to start asking yourself those questions. What is the agent reading to discover? What is the main point that the reader or the agent is going to unravel by reading your story? What really is the selling point of your story, and what is the payoff of reading it? Think through all of those things as you're crafting this final sentence. So the example from the blurb that I gave you in the beginning is, "And as fragile relationships hang in the balance and close alliances shift, Malin must test the limits of what she's capable of to stop the truth from coming out." I really like this closing line because the phrase, "she's going to test the limits of what she's capable of," really makes the person reading it wonder what exactly she's going to do and what that entails and how far she's going to go. Of course, we also want to know what that truth is that she's trying so hard to protect. All of that is really wrapped up in this closing line, and it does really make you want to read the book. If I were to recraft this closing line as a rhetorical question to use in the blurb, it could be something like, "How much is Malin willing to sacrifice in order to stop the truth from coming out?" So you could go both ways. Make it a hard stop sentence that's really exciting and suspenseful, or actually pose it as a question itself. Now, I've already talked about this a little bit, but the biggest don't to keep in mind with the blurb is you don't want to spoil the ending, even in this closing line. Writers often get confused here because, again, in the synopsis document, which is a separate document from the query letter, you do want to give away the ending very clearly and very deliberately. In the blurb, though, again, it's like a movie trailer. If the movie trailer gives away the ending, which, you know, some kind of feel like they do, then you're kind of like, eh, that wasn't really making me want to watch the movie because I feel like I already know what happens. So don't do that with your blurb. Again, think back to the book jacket copy or description copy. That's really what it should sound like. It doesn't give away the ending. It really just makes you want to open the book and read it. So as you're working on your novel blurb, I do recommend reading the jacket copy or the description copy of other books in your genre or just books that you really love, and then model your blurb after those and then follow some of their similar structures. A question I often get asked about the novel blurb is, how long should it be? This really should be no longer than 3 or 4 paragraphs, and those should be short paragraphs of just a couple of sentences. Remember, less is more, and you really want to keep it short and sweet because, again, the agent is really just going to be skimming that query letter before scrolling down to your sample pages. And in fact, the most common edit I make whenever I am working on a client's query letter is really shortening the plot blurb. I hope these tips help you craft an exciting and enticing novel blurb for your query letter. And if you are looking for some more tips on how to catch agents' attention, I recommend checking out my video on the top elements of a successful query letter, where I go through all of the factors that really make a query letter stand out in an agent's submission inbox. Now, if you found this video helpful, please hit that like button below and check out the rest of my channel. Hit that subscribe button if you're so inclined. I would love to have you around to talk all things book writing and publishing. Thanks so much for watching, and happy writing.